Hi, it's Michelle Taberge, and today I'm addressing a specific question that I think will help a lot of you. And I'm going to read the whole context of the question, but just as an overview, the question is, how do I start a painting? But let's get a little background. So this comes from Francesca Costanzo, and she writes, "My career in advertising and marketing design spans some 30 years. 1 year ago, I took a break from all this and decided I wanted to paint. I have never painted in my entire life, save for my younger years, 10, 11, 12. Needless to say, it's been a challenge. My painter colleagues keep telling me, just keep painting through it. I have those days where I produce mud, and other days where I produce colors that just jump off the page and into the heart. Anyway, I'm writing you since I've been watching many of your videos throughout this year of growth. You just have a natural way of coming across, and it is obvious that your videos are to teach and instruct rather than to say, look how great I am, and you can be too. But Francesca, I am great, and you can be too." Anyway, I get what you're saying. Thank you for the compliment. That all said, I'm at a crossroads. I keep painting, keep walking through it, and it seems that my paintings, while they maintain a certain sense of consistency, are inconsistent. Does that make sense? What I mean is that they are all painted from the seat of my pants without anything in mind. It's all very different from my graphic design techniques. Painting is tough. I think there's a lot of people who would agree with that statement. Can you lend any encouragement specific to how to start a new painting? Should I just calm down and let it flow? Or does it need to have a set direction at the outset, like graphic design? I'm really stuck and can't seem to get through this. And again, my artist painter colleagues who have been doing this for 30 years just keep saying, just paint through it. If anything, thanks for listening. So this is a really rich question, and I could probably riff on this for quite a long time, but I'm going to try and be concise and get as much as I can to you in this video. I would tend to agree with your painter friends, just keep painting through it, but as a teacher for many years, I think there's more that I can give you. Things that they may have resolved long ago that you're just beginning to dig into and to understand. And I think this is, when you said painting is tough, this is what happens when we pursue it, I don't want to say seriously, because I don't feel like painting has to be serious. I think it can be light, it can be fun, it can be easy, it can be joyous. If that's your approach, and it can be like serious, and it can be hard work and all that, if that's your approach too. I would say either path can be joyful, satisfying, fulfilling, and that's the artist's choice. So I'm not saying one is better or one is worse. And I probably vacillate between a little bit of both. But I would say, I guess first I would say, usually it's not the painting itself that's tough, it's the thoughts that are happening in our head while we're painting. It's judgments. It could be not being comfortable with confusion, not being able to sit through not knowing. This is inherent parts of the creative process, and I try to address these things really specifically in my unfolding of a painting series, on my YouTube series that's taking me through developing some paintings, and I'm trying to share really honestly what things I go through as I make the paintings. So there's that. So there are strategies for dealing with the thoughts, and many of the things I teach my students, one of the most helpful I would find is to have some kind of a journal, art journal. In fact, I have a couple right here on the shelf. Those are mine, and so they might be things that I write in before starting, just to kind of clear, empty my head. Or it could be something that, as I'm pondering things, but one technique I specifically give a lot of my students, especially if you're bothered by thoughts during the painting process, this may not be you, this may apply to others who are watching the video, but bear with me here. So a lot of times the critical inner voice comes up, it starts telling us this is crap, this is no good, you know, what do you think you're doing, you know, just give this up or whatever it is, give this up. Sometimes people don't even step back from those thoughts, but they are those thoughts, they embody those thoughts, and they do put the thing down. I've gotten emails from people who've like thrown work out, crumpled it up, just walked away. But I'd like you to put some distance between you and those thoughts. And so keeping, it could be a notebook or a journal, or it could just be a little scrap of paper that you just jot the things down. And if you have a hard time stepping back and suddenly you know you're in that downward spiral with your thoughts, then I would suggest even going so far as to set a timer while you're painting and pause. Every 10, 20, 15 minutes, you can find your rhythm with an appropriate interval. Some people hear me say that and think, how horrible is that? But I actually have a really nice meditation timer on my iPhone, and it's beautiful, just tone. And if you've, you know, been in a meditation setting where they ring a bell, it just centers you and brings you back. And so you hear that bell and you just breathe, come into your body, breathe again, notice how you're feeling in your body, notice what thoughts have been up for you that you've been entertaining in your head, so to speak, because you are allowed to show those thoughts the door if they're not thoughts that are supporting you. So, but getting some distance on them, and as far as showing the thoughts the door. I mean, that technique can work for some people. I think I find more just embracing them, but not embodying them. So just saying, I hear you, you're there. Okay, I've heard that before. You know, this is no good, you're a bunch of crap, whatever that negative voice is. So that's one thought I have for you. So managing the thoughts, dealing with the thoughts that are coming up during the painting process. Okay, but then let's step back and let's talk about creating an overall strategy, because this is what happens when you go from, say, a student painter to someone who's functioning on their own, who's developing work, a trajectory, a body of work, a series or whatnot. So I think what you might need to do, if you haven't already, is take out all your paintings and sit down with them and spend a good long time looking at them and thinking about them. Because it sounds like you've been painting a lot, so I'm guessing at this point you've put together some kind of a body of work. And let the paintings tell you where you need to go. So by that I mean you're going to sit down with your journal, and you're going to, again, coming from that centered, sort of dispassionate place, not attached. Not attached. Is this a good painting? Is it a bad painting? Just noticing. I call this the noticing exercise. So when people work with me, I have us do, and it is helpful, it depends again where you are. Some listeners have a really strong inner critic and need to just balance that out with positive thoughts. So they may need to write like 10 things they like about a painting, or a body of work, you know, a group of paintings. And then, you know, a few things that you'd like to change. You know, just take notes. And then see if there's connections. See if anything is developing. So I think part of the thing is not to just go in and just always, I mean, I think it's great, you know, especially depending again where you are in your painting practice, how long you've been painting. I'm a huge advocate for just go in there and just paint. Don't think about it, you know, but that's easier said than done. And a lot of people have the thought, so they have to think about it and they have to pull back and they have to have some intentionality. But I do think that many of us at a certain point will find it more satisfying to think more deeply. I don't know if I want to use the word strategically because it sounds a little calculated, but just think from a bigger perspective, a broader perspective about what these paintings are about, what they're teaching me, what they have to offer others, or what they potentially have to offer others, and what's interesting to me in them. it always has to first be about you. Where do you find the satisfaction? Because you're the creator, so you're not going to be able to serve anyone with your work if you aren't served by it first, if that makes sense. So take some time, think about it, and let me know how that goes. I'd be really curious, anyone who's listening to this video, who's getting this advice,